Welcome back, everyone, for this final set of episodes for A Link to the Past. As always, we've got Ambi.
Hello.
As usual, we've got Snow.
Howdy.
And as attempted in the past, we've got Roxy.
Yo.
Attempted.
So this time things should work out, since everything should be settled technically.
And please, everyone, check from time to time that Audacity's fucking recording. That one's for you, Ambi.
I checked. I've got to open in a tab so I can see.
I said time to time. Time to time.
Constantly. Got to check it constantly.
This is why you got a second monitor specifically so you could just see that it's recording.
I remember mentioning that before. So, we're pretty well set for the final run. We've got everything, basically. There's still a couple things to get that I'm going to grab really quick before we get to Dungeon 7. That'll just take us a moment.
My least favorite dungeon.
Pieces of heart.
We've got one piece of heart in the final dungeon, and then the heart container from beating it. So that'll get us done with hearts.
The hammer just looks like a rubber mallet to me. I'll never let it go.
Oh, you'll like the last set of episodes that I don't have up yet, because while I was doing the sword retempering, I just used it as my alternate melee weapon for about, like, nearly an entire episode.
Nice.
So, look what we've got in stock here now.
My favorite.
Just take the ball.
About 150 rupees or something. When I hit the R button, it'll have a countdown to explosion.
Or if you get hit.
Does it do when you get hit? I'll be careful and try to avoid that then.
I know on the Super Nintendo version, if you got hit...
Oh, whoops.
Wow.
When you jump down a ledge, though, it does.
Wow.
So, if you get separated at all, it...
Don't tell me you have to buy another one.
Well, yes.
Sorry, starting off on the right foot.
Yeah.
I guess this is what you need all those rupees for in the late game.
Yeah.
To buy this bomb about 20 times.
I like that the bomb fucking breathes.
Yeah, it's a little bit frightening. Because I keep getting worried that it's about to go off or something. Going to bring this around to the Pyramid of Power.
So if you tried to warp with the bomb, would the bomb go off, or would it like...
It would go
off. That's what I assumed, but I didn't want to test it.
Trust me, I probably spent over an hour trying to get it to this location.
Ah, I see. It's a crack, but...
Yep. It's a crack we tried to break before, but nothing would get through.
So we just needed a bigger bomb.
That's really the solution to anything.
Are there any other cracks like this?
This is the only one, I think.
Thank God, because it would suck if you had to do this like 3 more times.
It really would. So, we've got another wishing well where we can throw something in.
Throw in the fucking fairy.
No.
Let me try that first.
Don't actually throw in the fairy.
Okay.
We love the fairy.
The fairy is kind to us.
Our sword?
What if you got a shittier... Well, okay. You got a better sword. Yes! Power throbbing in your hand! Oh god. Who translated that?
Oh
Why did
my.
They
But that's not the only thing we've got here.
There wasn't the shield and your pants.
So can you
throw yourself into there?
Can you skip the sword tempering next step? Just straight get this, or
if you do that, it actually takes you to level 3, and then if you do the sword tempering, that brings you to level 4. Mm-hmm.
That's a mess.
So they made sure that you couldn't mess it up.
To deal the final stroke. I see.
I didn't remember it this way.
Alright. Now we are completely prepared.
This is the first time where it's just silver arrows instead of light arrows.
Yep. That backfired.
He came down to swoop and pick you up and he fucking had to miss it. That's cute.
Yeah. Adrian showed us last episode you can dodge the bird.
Yeah.
That comes to pick you up.
If you want to be a jerk.
So now let's head our way back to Turtle Rock.
Keep getting squished by the boulders.
I hate those boulders.
I think they hate you too. I think it's a mutual. I think you're in kiss-mises.
Kiss me boulder.
Christ. Kiss me tude.
R.I.P. Homestuck.
How dare you!
No, I'm honoring it.
Yeah, Homestuck is dead. Dead. Long live Homestuck.
Just in time.
That's one way to do it.
Just fuck it. I'm going invisible.
Oh my god, I just realized. Since the Link of Ocarina of Time is the hero of time, does that mean that's their aspect in Homestuck?
Yes.
I would say yes.
Has someone done a Legend of Zelda and Homestuck crossover yet?
Actually, yes.
If they haven't, you should be the first Roxy. Oh, they have still?
Yeah, it would be the logical progression. Because there's a hero of time and there's the hero of winds because of Wind Waker.
Yeah.
And then the hero of Twilight, which is,
Twilight Princess.
Twilight Princess, so I don't know, maybe Void or some shit.
A lot of them have official epithets like that, some of them don't.
Yeah.
But there's a few fan ones or ones that I just make up myself.
Have the first image that comes up.
I remember this! Oh yeah, that was so good! Oh, what a time. What a time to be alive. That's perfect.
Oh, Death Mountain.
These things just remind me of Goombas with wings. Very original Nintendo.
Unfortunately, they're also immortal, which is annoying. You turn to stone, but then they just turn back eventually.
Pity you can't pick them up and throw them off the mountain.
So this one, yeah. Here we get something familiar from Misery Mire. Works the same way to unlock Quake Medallion.
Just quake that turtle up.
Nope, you killed it. Good job.
Before we head in.
Compensation.
Fortunately, it's just the one paw, it looks like. Double rupees.
Level 7. Thanks for the magic. Well.
Is that a question mark?
Yes, it is. To get through, you need the Cane of Samaria. Without it, you literally can't get into the dungeon even.
Well.
This is a cane, by the way, you might remember, that normally creates a block when you use it.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Was that the one that we were talking about last time that I was like, don't you need the red one or some shit?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I was wondering if, like, if getting the gold, the silver arrows, had reset our capacity?
Oh, no. It turns yellow when you're at max. I just don't have max right now.
Oh, the jerk who designed this level.
Ooh, yeah.
It's jerks who designed the Zelda games in general.
The water temple.
Oh damn.
Oops. The fucking Okokos or whatever from Twilight Princess. Why would you put a human face on a chicken?
What the fuck is this?
Are you just... Nice. Very nice, Sidran.
Gotta trick your way past the eye guards, or whatever they're called.
Let's see, what are those called? I have the list here. Laser Eye.
Snow is our official researcher, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Since I can't be spoiled. Very original name,
I've forgotten all their names.
I can't pronounce half of them, so we're equal there.
This is just a mean tile room.
Not even any pattern. Well, maybe a pattern.
Couldn't you use your shield to block the tile?
I kind of don't want to risk trying it.
Because you're afraid you might bounce back?
Yeah, okay. You cannot. Yep.
Okay.
You can hold your sword out and have them run into it sometimes, though. Like charging your sword. And it made a boss goal.
Skull.
For no compensation.
Well,
recharge room. That's horrible.
Oh my god. Idran.
Whoops.
Rookie mistakes, Idran. We're in the last fucking dungeon.
It's another one.
Worst speedrun ever. So you can probably see what the idea for this room is after I take a few trips around this track.
Pure dickishness.
Does it fall into the void?
And don't forget the lamps have time limits.
Because they love you. And though what you might not be able to notice without the controller in your hand is you do have some control over the platform.
Yep, whenever you have one of those crossover points, the ones that look like the wider dotted line, you can hold a direction to decide which way you go with those. But if there's no wider point, if it's just a crossover the track or goes over and under, you don't.
What is that? Is it just a giant laser rolling thing?
It's a giant spike bar.
A spike roll, technically, but very creative naming there, too.
Yeah, think of a roller pin with nails in it, I guess.
Yep.
Or a hairbrush, I guess. One of those.
Yeah. Now that we've got the map and compass, let's take a look at what we're in for. Not a huge dungeon.
Seems reasonably linear.
You would be wrong.
Yeah, unfortunately, Turtle Rock is a dungeon that's very easy to get lost in. And we'll see why pretty soon, after this Hokuboku.
I feel like a lot of these enemies we've never seen ever again in the later Zelda games.
Yeah, Link to the Past had a lot of unique ones. These ones, not so much here.
Oh, hey. Hi, jumpers.
Literally a chain chomp.
So that was just kind of mean.
So what do you have to do here?
Unlock that chest.
Okay.
Yeah, that was kind of dickish. I remember not finding that for a long time.
This is why I did a practice run this time.
Oh.
You can turn the evil fairies into regular fairies with magic power. If you're accurate enough.
Yeah.
Ooh, dang, what's this? So I take it that you can get hurt by
the bouncing ones? Yep. Yeah. But if you kill them early, then they've got a pretty good chance of dropping a pretty nice item. A lot of times they'll drop a fairy or a big jar if you kill one of the bouncing ones before it disappears. Hmm. So that's something.
What's the symbol on the little tubes?
What is that? I don't recognize it.
It looks like it looks like some type of ice staff symbol we've seen before in another game.
It kind of reminds me of the Sheikah symbol.
A little. Also reminds me of a smiling guy with a big nose.
Well, there is that. Didn't even think of that. How dare you?
Yeah. Could
so,
be someone
left or right?
Left.
I say left.
Honor Raj.
Actually, it is very close to the Sheikah symbol. The eye with the 3 points.
Hmm.
Dang it, fairy, get over here. Fuck's sake, fairy.
Jesus Christ! That's hilarious.
It did not love you.
The game is not playing well with you today.
Wow.
Just cheese.
So those bouncing things are made out of wood, I see.
I didn't have time for its nonsense. Oh, big key room.
You know what? Actually, I really hope that there's a game in the future where we learn more about the Sheikah.
That would be cool, yeah. Really, any Zelda game that was more lore heavy would be cool.
Yeah.
Well, that's interesting. I didn't realize that you could destroy pots with the golden sword.
Yes, as long as you charge it up.
Don't die, Adrian.
So, what is the secret to these eyes?
Some of them, they only fire when they face you. Some of them, they fire whenever they see you. We're going to take a quick side stop as we come out here.
How would you ever know?
You wouldn't.
Well, unless you saw it in the light world, that there is that one balcony that there is literally no other way to get to.
Mm.
Remember how much trouble the Cyclops guys gave us before in the first dungeon?
Yep, and now we one shot them.
It's a good feeling there.
Yeah.
Piece of heart. Piece of heart.
One heart to go. Oh, I don't have a big key.
Damn.
So close.
Supply.
Oh, right. Lasers.
Lasers! Dickishness, that's for sure.
Then let's head back out and try the other tunnel. That just seems really painful, by the way. Especially with the sound at each corner.
Yeah.
Oh, that was nice. Yeah. Because they're all together.
Oh, that skull just phased out the wall. And we're a bunny now.
The golden sword, by the way, the strongest sword in Zelda. Any game. Because each higher level of sword in this game doubles your strength. There's actually someone that compared the damage by corresponding swords that appeared in multiple games, and this one worked out to be the best.
Yay.
Finally.
Took us long enough.
What do you mean, finally? It's only taken us, like, 20 minutes.
Finally! Adrian also died. It's supposed to be a perfect run.
I should start the LP all over.
Why start not? The LP. Do a not getting hit, zero damage run. Just gotta restart every time you take damage.
Do a three heart run.
No. We'd be here all week.
Oh, you're really overestimating my skills, no.
Idren, you fell.
I said overestimating.
Okay. I was gonna say, like, you walked off the ledge.
Fell off a cliff, had to restart the game.
Oh, you don't even have to charge it up. Nice. I'm not wasting my magic.
You have so much!
Mirror shield. Oh, like beams.
Nice tower shield.
It's so huge. It blocks our face.
The mirror shield also comes up in other games.
Yeah.
Hey. Fountains of loot.
With bomb spots.
I say top. Never mind.
You're too slow. Oh.
So that noise that you heard after those enemies is what allows you to actually push this block. Before then, it's unmovable.
And then pull the tongues again, or a tongue.
Yep.
And holy Jesus.
Do you need money for a bomb?
He needs
Some
to put,
days,
you
just can't get rid of a bomb.
He needs to put a down payment. On a new car or some shit, so that's why he's gotta just bear it. You ever make a joke that you think, alright, it's probably good, but as soon as you say, like, the first three words, it just dies in your head, so you're like, I'm gonna have to just come up with something as
you're
I'm saying it.
You're committed to it?
Yeah, you have to commit to it. It'll be mediocre, but if you get a chuckle, then it's alright.
What if you don't get a chuckle, though?
Then you're not my real friends.
Oh. We're sorry. I'd say we tried better, but we can't make promises like that in this stream.
I have 100% success rate with my jokes on these streams. 100%.
It's true. I've done the math.
As I said earlier, major dickishness in this dungeon.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. How did you...
The hookshot invulnerability frames.
Yeah.
Wow.
Adrian's favorite thing.
Wow, I've never seen that. That's amazing. You lucky bastard. Damn. This would have made my life way easier when I did this.
See, this is why we don't believe Adrian when he's like, I have no skills. Like, you use invulnerability frames all the time.
I don't think knowledge counts as skills.
True.
Not for video games, at least.
You still have to be able to pull it off.
Yeah,
I got hit
that's
once.
That's the flaw.
Twice! That's good. That's enough for me. Adrian's still a human. He checks out.
I mean, the knowledge is one thing, but being able to actually do it and get the time off. That's the skill part.
Well, timing isn't a huge thing. Kind of just feel it.
Yeah.
Says you, music major.
True. Well, everyone has an internal sense of temporality.
And that's mine is broken.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry for you.
That's why I don't wake up in the mornings. It's all
broken.
Is
that why you're a vampire, Snow?
Yes, because I don't understand linear time.
Well, time is just... What the hell just happened?
There was... He charged across and there was a thing in there.
There was an attempt!
Oh, damn.
Oh.
See, they thought about that and they said, screw you.
Alright, so these eyes in this room here are the kind that only fire when you're facing them.
Mm-hmm.
So take a look at all those treasure chests.
Are they all empty?
It's not that cool, but you're not going to be able to get out of the treasure chest without taking at least one hit.
Bouncing octopus.
That's why you do this.
You just ignore them?
Well, first, let's take another quick side trip, because I believe there's a recharge room right here. Oh, not quite a recharge room, but close enough. We've been here before.
Oh yes, fall down one of those holes, restart the dungeon.
Thankfully, the Dark World portal stays wherever you leave it until you use the magic mirror again.
Or do you use the shield to, like, deflect those things, can't you?
Yep.
Yes.
One way,
the issue
yes.
is you need to be facing it. Oh, wait. And I'm wrong, because these guys fire even when you're facing them.
Indeed.
So, that's why you do this.
What? Oh my god.
Because it sends you back to wherever you entered the dungeon from.
You're gonna burn in hell, Adrian.
I just did that for you, Roxy.
Good.
And I'm not gonna bother with these other chests, because they're basically just little things. That don't
they're just rupees.
Like,
who gives a shit anymore?
Yeah.
I have 428 rupees.
Just need the key from one, and we're done.
Now we come to a crystal switch maze.
So tricks.
Hammer.
Even the mighty hammer is powerless against a shield on your head.
Well, maybe you need to hit its butt or something?
Yeah, probably. But pot works just as well.
It worked on the big one.
You literally need to tap that ass. See? 100% success rate. Those little things kind of remind me of pumpkins.
Yeah, they kind of do now that I think about it.
They seem to be made out of wood because, like, they burn instantly, so...
Yeah.
Have you ever tried to burn a pumpkin? It works.
Mississippi is very weird.
Hey, you've never heard it.
It's Mississippi.
True.
Don't let Mr. Sippy hear you saying that. Be very funny.
That offended me.
I didn't laugh for that reason. I was like, I glared at the screen.
So you can take a look what we might be in for based on this boss symbol.
Three faces.
Here we come to Trinex. And this is why you want to keep the magic meter filled. And why you want to make sure you've got some magic potions. This is going to be an Ice Rod and Fire Rod fight.
The fire fight.
The fire damages you. The ice works just like any other ground ice.
So cute. So funny.
Such a pain.
No penguins, unfortunately.
You know what would be funny? If you made it like ice half of the room, and then it slips as it walks over that, if you make it chase you.
That would be. Thankfully, with the golden sword, we don't have much to worry about damage-wise.
His neck extends so far.
Yep.
Yeah, the ice half is a bit of a pain.
Yep.
Oh, it didn't.
Especially once we get to this phase.
Oh, this part.
This is the turtle of Turtle Rock.
That's no turtle. That's a snake.
Hey, it had a shell. It had a home.
We destroyed it. The poor
dead
little
snake.
Thing.
That golden sword makes mincemeat of things.
Yeah.
And the final heart.
Well, like I said, every level doubles the damage from the last one, so...
Okay.
We're sorry, your princess is in another castle.
Princess in another crystal. So what I'm taking from this is he's going to do it, and then we're going to stop him.
Boy, he about to do it!
Always trust
Ganon. Find him wherever he wants.
Always trust Ganon to make the dramatic entrance.
Dynamic entry.
I think that's how you can tell the difference between someone who's evil and someone who's just occasionally bad.
The dramatic entrance?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd agree with that.
Someone's truly evil, like, enters every scene with, you know, dynamic entry, boot to the face.
Their own orchestra behind them every time.
Then again, though, Francis York Morgan, he's got a pretty good door entrance.
Who?
True.
Are you talking about Deadly Premonition?
Yep.
We don't bring up other games during this live stream.
Oh no, we do it all the time.
How dare
time.
You? This is Zelda! Have
I bring
some
up
respect.
Honor, like, at least once an episode.
Remember, by the way, Andy, earlier when you were wondering what the dark world version of Death Mountain is like.
Holy shit! Are those buff old lion centaurs?
Yep.
That's me in 50 years.
What are they called, Snow?
Buff old lion centaurs.
Lionel.
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 Lionel. Bring me the sword!
Christ, oh my...
Here we are, Ganon's Tower. Damn.
Thundercats, ho!
Why are you saying in that voice? No!
Snarf!
That's it, I'm done. I can't laugh anymore for the rest of the stream.
Alright, let's bring the house down. Thank you.
How does that work? Nobody knows.
Or sage magic. Door, I guess.
Well, you know, I think it's in the same way that, like, when you go into these ancient temples and movies and they have these really intricate traps and shit planned with just, like, twine and boulders, and you're like, how the fuck? But it just happens. It just does.
6 floors of tower.
Not counting the basement.
I'm noticing a bit of a pig theme here.
Yep.
Yeah, he's
a pig. I think holding a Triforce, even.
He's a piggy.
Peeker.
Let's check out the basement before we head up.
True Ganon is a boar. Ha, ha, ha.
Ho, 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 ho. Clubber.
Sprightly little guys.
Oh, Stealthos.
Just arrows. Just arrows. Thanks, game. I didn't know that.
Yeah, that's kind of a thing with Zelda, giving you those reminders even at the very end of the game. But what does this lever do?
Regret. I can bet money on regret.
Yeah, yeah.
The answer was indeed regret.
Oh, come on. Oh, come on!
Is that a wall master?
Yes, it is.
Why?
Okay, I'm gonna at least try and cut down a little of it. The tiles can frame interrupt your magic powder. There.
Because if you use a sword, you get shot. If you get hit.
Yep. Those things there, they shoot out fireballs when you swing your sword.
Mm. Oh, holy Christ.
So...
This room.
Sets a theme for the whole dungeon, doesn't it?
Yep.
And we've got some Gibdos here.
Oh man, it's been a while.
I say we no longer need fire to kill them, because our sword is so hench.
Yep.
Dick two bomb.
Okay, that'll give me an excuse to check the top. Oh, there's another way down. Okay.
This place does not love you.
Oh, it's the mirror, guys.
Yep. The Gorias. This is an interesting variant on a crystal switch maze.
You...
Oh, took damage. Oh, no, you didn't.
Yeah, because he got, like, stabbed by the blocks.
Didn't actually take damage, thankfully. It just puts you in invincibility frames. Yeah.
Okay.
Can you block those fireballs now?
Oh, you are right. I probably can. Thank you, Ambi.
Face danger in the face. God damn it. Face danger in the face. It. Really. Shoot it in the face!
That's how I solve most of my puzzles.
It's kind of like Lucy in the Sky of Diamonds. Shoot it in the face with arrows.
That was terrible, and I hope you feel bad.
I don't even know what he was referencing.
So this is... I don't have 100% success rate, but what I do have is much better. I have jokes that make people afraid to laugh.
Sure, let's quote it as that.
What was even the reference?
Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds.
As in the song by the Beatles?
Yes.
You're saying you would shoot Lucy in the sky with in the face?
No.
That's what you just said! I'm so confused.
Makes sense to me.
So this is how you're supposed to handle Beasgorius. Use the fact that its speed doesn't change when you push stuff. Because you can't just hang out thanks to the spike traps. You can do that, though.
You just quickscope them. Can we block these lasers?
You cannot. Nothing can stop the Beanos.
So rude.
In other Zelda games, you can use bombs.
Yeah.
This game, less forgiving.
Ah, the big key. Just back to the entrance.
Oh, this just leads us right here. Good. Now I get to handle this. Oh, it's already open. Thank you.
Oh, thank Jesus.
Oh. Where's the fun in that?
I would really like to have the map or compass at some point. The Wallmaster's gonna... Yeah.
Oh, man.
Now the question is, will it respawn?
The answer is almost definitely yes.
Of course it will.
Case in point.
Can the Wallmaster get you during hookshots and vulnerability period?
Probably.
Because
yeah, it's a jerk like that, I bet.
It has a long grab period, so it probably bypasses your time.
Yeah. That would make sense. This is nothing but a recharge room. Why am I hanging out here? Gotta do the lamp thing. There's another lamp up here. Yep. Oh, this is mean.
That is indeed mean.
Hmm. Oh, man.
And of course, you're...
There's four lamps? Ah.
Yes, there are.
Okay. So first, I'm going to kill the Wallmaster.
At least the lamps seem to stay lit for, like, a decent amount of time.
Yeah. Not like the Joe Rock room. Where is...
There he is. We did it! Hey! Well, I mean, Edrin did it, and we lent moral support.
I'll count it.
We're quietly cheering in the background.
Hey. Oh, throw a bomb.
Yes.
Oh, you're right. I was thinking I'd have to do something like that, but okay.
I saw the conversion. I see, it's my Bomberman instincts. It's like, ah, this looks like a problem that can be solved by explosions.
If you can time it right. Thankfully, it looks like we're not getting a Wallmaster here, because it would have fallen by now if we did.
Sometimes the best solutions are the ones you don't think of. Like using all your palms.
Oh, wait, no, the block. You can pick the block up and then, like, detonate it afterwards, can't you?
Oh, you're right. I should have done that.
Well, I was wrong once and right once, so...
I think you were right about the intended way. It's just very, very particular about timing, because it did work on that last one.
Hmm. But just getting past the second one requires triggering it. So, well, maybe you could throw it.
Yeah, if you're well timed, then no.
You can do the bomb, it's just a pain in the...
Oh, wow. Wow.
It's like, here, take this compass and all of these pits. Well, ain't that just the pits?
How am I going to get that last chest?
Can you hookshot the walls?
You could possibly push the block.
Which direction can you... Oh, yeah, okay, maybe. Well, I'll try that.
Either that or exit the room and try again. Huzzah.
Alright, so instead of taking that warp tile, because I don't know where it's actually going to take me, I'm going to just backtrack. And... never mind?
Yeah, because that violates the scientific method. How dare you?
Nice little menagerie here.
I'm not sure if dicks
seem to lead anywhere.
But there's a far end, which I'm guessing means that that warp tile was the way I was supposed to go earlier. So, good job, me.
Nice try, though.
Yeah. I'm probably gonna have to do the lamp thing again. But well.
Alright, well, it falls to the scientific mind.
Have a hypothesis, this dungeon is evil. Test it, this dungeon is quite evil. Congratulations. Try it again, just to be sure.
At least you learned the first time.
Yes, I did. Well, this is somewhere new, but it's not where I was expecting to go.
Those doors can't mean anything good.
What for the toad, geez. What lovely things. Reminds me of the quote, like the Hellraiser scene. What sights we have to show you.
Well, that could have been worse.
Imagine trying to find your way to the bathroom in this mess.
Gotta go fast.
Yes, you do.
Oh, wow. Oh boy.
Speaking of which...
You called it, Ambie.
Oh, I didn't think it was that going to go fast. I was just saying you gotta go fast to get past the flame things. But not that fast.
Or you could just use the, invincibility cape.
Oh, right. That is something that I have.
Ah, well. We don't have that much magic left anyway.
Yeah.
Most perturbatory.
Wow. Good luck.
Oh, I think I know what the trick is here. So first, let's get rid of the beetle. And now let's see what happens if I hookshot myself across the warp tile. If I get close enough.
You're gonna fall.
Yeah.
I guess we gotta move the statue closer first.
Oh.
Or that.
That's a lot easier.
Until you can get around it.
I think we can just go around it, because like we navigated the other side.
There we go.
Yeah. This dungeon.
What is this nonsense?
Light a torch and we will find out. Oh.
Yeah. You take a wild step in the dark and guess that those bridges are only active while the fire is.
Yes, you would probably be correct there.
Seems logical to me. Though I'm hoping they're just invisible passages.
Why would this dungeon be that kind?
Oh, from looking at the beetle, it looks like that is correct.
Huh. Well, there's an easy way to figure it out, then.
Trial and error.
No hard hat beetles.
We do have a red cane that can put blocks on solid surfaces.
We do.
And we have a curse on us to double our magic.
And we've also got an Aether Medallion.
What's that do?
Get rid of pests.
Oh! Yeah. It shows you.
I did not know it did that. Clever, clever, clever.
Yep. Unfortunately, it's a little draining.
Oh, there's a fireball.
Thankfully, it can help pay for itself. If you are lucky with your hammer. Ah.
I guess this is the dungeon they should have warned you to bring a potion for.
Yeah, I do have potions. I'm just not sure if I want to use them now. Okay. I'm low on health too, why not?
Couldn't you just go to the top and shoot the fire to the lantern?
Yeah, I probably should do that, but I am stubborn. It is my only flaw.
Of course, your only flaw.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay. It's a thing about freezing enemies that when you hammer them, you often get a big pot of magic back.
Why? Who knows?
It helps out with the ice rod, at least, and with your magic.
This is not a kind dungeon.
Very much not.
Another petty little spark.
Hey. Replace that fairy.
Yeah.
Is there something to do with this like statue in the middle? Or?
I'm gonna try the floors first.
Hmm.
Okay, so we've got a pit to fall down in the basement here. We haven't been in the basement yet, so let's try it.
Tally ho.
Oh, these guys.
On an ice floor, too.
Shh. Weren't these a boss?
Yep.
This is the first boss, the Armus Knights.
Oh, okay, so we're doing the boss rush.
And they have a crap ton more health, it looks like.
Well, they've always been really resistant to sword. I should be using arrows from the start.
Oh, those silver arrows.
They do just instantly disintegrate.
I mean, to be fair, we do have evil sling arrows.
Nice.
Dang, sir. Oop. Three chests. Hey, the big key.
That wasn't too bad.
Yeah.
Some arrows and balls.
Just too bad it doesn't respawn every time you re-enter the room.
Yeah.
I can't get through the
ice floors and doors. Ice floors and doors.
Match made in heaven.
Now that's just ultra dense.
At least it's obvious. Not one of those falling floors.
Oh well, that's kind. Unreasonably so.
Oh, Rebel.
Oh, cool.
Hey. No, nice. Oh, I was gonna say, no,
it's
we
about
didn't
time
look
the
like
game cuts
anymore.
You some slack. What? Yeah.
I was gonna say, no, we don't look like shit anymore, but that... we're still like a clashing color palette.
That color
it's just because of his hair, I guess. And the hat.
The purple hat.
Yeah, the hat.
Yeah. Like, if it was just the red mail and like a red hat, that would be beautiful. But, it's the red, it's like red and then the purple hat, the pink hair, and then green sleeves.
It is a little bit all over the map. Hookshot maze here.
Well, we can go up easily. And that looks to be a dead end, so... It's a treasure room! Full of bones! And things.
Oh, you have to defend your treasury.
Yeah.
How better than necromancy?
I'm not sure necromancers are the best form of, like, protecting your capitalism, so.
You don't have to pay the animated dead.
Being the Lich King never works out.
One day it will.
It's just not this. It's just not fiscally responsible. I mean, they spend all that money on Black Onyx to, like, reanimate their spells. There you go, there's an episode title, Animate Dead.
Just...
Have I not used that one yet?
We might have.
Whatever.
Destroy all my hopes and dreams.
Alright, locked doors. Always have important things.
This looks like a job for Hookshot. It's the map! Hey! Wonder what that tile does.
It probably makes hits appear in annoying places. Let's take a look what we've got left to do.
Some rooms over to the right.
Quite a bit.
Quite a bit.
This is the tricky one, because if I just put a bomb next to it willy-nilly, it might hit both switches. Gotta be careful about your positioning.
Willy-nilly?
Yes, it's a word. Sometimes.
Technically two words.
I always hyphenate it.
I never write that word ever.
This will be fun. I'll just get out of the way in advance.
Yeah. Unleash.
Will the spike block activate the... Well, I guess we won't get a chance to see.
Well, that backfired.
Oh god.
Invisibility! That went sour fast.
My block looked a little suspicious.
As they do.
Okay. That we immediately use. Oh god, no, it's a teleporter mad maze. These are my least favorite thing.
And this seems to be a different room.
Yeah.
So it's not just between the same point.
Just to add in an extra bit of difficulty.
They're in every single, like, psychic Pokemon gym and every Pokemon game. Oh, it's this room.
I guess that could have gone worse. If I go through this, is it going to scold or me? No. Did I take the wrong path? I think I took the wrong path.
I think you're fine.
Okay, I see what it did now. Because if we do try and get through this way, because we've been in this room before, we're blocked off. Okay.
Oh.
A different type of skull door.
Huh.
I gotta mess with this again.
Let's just use fire and call it a day.
Yeah.
Did we go through that top door before? Or?
From the map we did.
At least to the big chest there?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, we already got that. Yeah,
that was where the red mail was. Not a fan of beetles, by the way.
Nope.
I wonder why.
See, it's one thing to have knockback when you get hit by an enemy. It's another thing to have knockback when you hit an enemy.
Couldn't...
That's just me.
Couldn't you use the ether medallion to...
Oh, to freeze them all? Yeah, that's a good point. I should do that. I think it only works when they're on screen, though, so I will hold it once I get close to one that can't reach me. But thank you, Roxy.
You're welcome.
Be hilarious if it puts a lantern out there.
I'll wait until I'm over here just in case that does happen.
Oh, wait, as well.
Oh, I could just use the... I'm going to assume that was just back timing.
I'm not, because that was beautiful.
Yeah.
Really bad timing there.
One heart.
Okay, so let's make our way back through. We've got Armus Knights that... Oh! I was worried about this.
Aww. Oh.
Yeah.
I got my wish.
Yeah, just arrow these bastards one more time.
At least the arrows just melt them.
Imagine if we didn't upgrade them, though.
Yeah. It feels like the silver arrows must be double damage or something. Which I am happy with. here. You know, I think I was supposed to go this way the whole time and not go back through that. Well.
You did say you're stubborn. It's your only flaw.
Okay, I'm supposed to go through the top.
You're supposed to head up a floor, aren't you?
Yeah, it's looking like it. I've got this thing again. Oh, and now we've got the big key, so we can get through that.
Why did all enemies respawn? Is it because we died?
I think there's a time limit that's fairly generous, but not infinite.
Not always the easiest thing to do.
Block, return. Parry, repost.
Christ.
Lasers hate him.
This one weird trick.
With a hook shot.
One of them just stuck really, really.
It's your favorite room concept, Ambi.
Oh god, no.
Can't see. And...
Oh, that's right, because there are more traps underneath that are stuck.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Oh. That made it easy.
There's.
Oh,
yeah.
Guys. And back we go.
I guess I could have gone worse.
Hmm. All things considered.
Oh.
Jesus.
That was pretty good.
Just stroll across the bridge.
I was gonna say use the magic cape, but okay. Oh.
Huh.
Oh.
I wondered.
It was on purpose?
Yep, because I wanted to get to this recharge room.
Oh.
That is the only place in the game where you have to use that trick to get somewhere. Are the fairies gonna respawn?
This fucking game.
I'm full up.
See,
anyway.
That's for sure that, like, the games in the past, you really needed... Like, that was actual skill.
Got these familiar friends.
In a conveyor belt room. My favorite.
Oh, that Beamos.
What about the sword lasers?
Yep.
We so rarely have them. It's always a surprise.
See, the nice thing about the red mail is this reduces damage so much that sometimes you'll have damage, but you won't have any visible hearts missing, because you're only missing, like, a quarter heart. And so long as the gauge is full, you have sword lasers.
That's pretty good.
The beam mills are going for a ride.
Oh, damn.
Why do they not love us?
everybody... Oh, well, you're using the freezing one. I was going to say everybody freeze, but... I guess everybody burns also works.
It's a bit faster. Just... Beamer room.
Just... bombs... bomb the shit out of everyone.
Bombs. Bombs.
Kaboom.
It's like the ice dungeon all over again. Nothing but bombos.
I miss the Pangators.
Oh, Pangators are great. Well, there's enough ice floors here. Maybe there's some in here.
Oh.
Oh, it's a boss room.
Yep, and here we have Lawnmolas. With an added Medusa.
An extra friend. However, we seem to have two shot one of them, so...
Yeah.
Still a pain in the butt.
A bit.
This is where Idran doesn't have the skill.
Yeah. And this is where it turns into a jerk.
You did it!
You did it. Yay.
Two down. So, what? Five. 10 to go?
Yep.
Is it all of them?
No. Thankfully, no.
Oh, jeez. I was gonna say, that seems a little punishing.
Oh, oh whiz robes?
Damn. I want to destroy all of you.
Yeah.
I'll take a chance on doing something tricky there. Okay.
Why wouldn't it be tricky? This dungeon loves you.
Nice and pale. Ooh. I can't remember, were those wizards like skull faces before?
I do not believe they were. These are upgraded versions of wizard robes.
That seem immune to being frozen.
They were out of phase, I think.
I think Gambi's right. They just immune to being frozen.
Like one of them died to the freezing, but
yeah.
The other two didn't.
Could have been a flicker.
Maybe it's just very, maybe just very particular timing.
Yeah. Oh, I hear it happening.
Don't see it. Oh, is it behind you?
Yeah.
Oh, yes it is.
They'll have the belts at least.
Okay. Okay, dungeon. If this is what you want.
Who hurt them to make them make this dungeon? Could you bomb most of the lights home?
It doesn't work for lamps.
Enemies get set on fire, but not lamps.
Yeah.
What type of
Well, enemies are a little bit more flammable than... Didn't realize it would hit me there.
I think there's still a light that you could... I don't know.
What type of discrimination is that?
I could have just lit the last
one. I'm going to sit here until this lamp goes out so I can time it right with the fire bar.
Oh, okay. I thought this was a boss room.
Not quite.
We're probably close, though.
Oh, no.
What is... Oh.
Oh!
Oh, no. What the fuck? Why?
Because it loves you.
Gotta go fast.
There you go.
Woo!
God damn it. These goddamn spike immune things. Bomb. Set some bomb traps for them if they're following you.
Hit his butt.
I see
you, Roxy.
Thanks.
Right in the butt.
Right in the butt. Of course. Why would it be anything else than this?
That bomb didn't move like a conveyor for some reason.
I think it was too far down.
Well, that can work to our advantage too. I guess. Okay. Hey.
Turned out well for us.
Yeah.
Hey, full magic.
Can you kill them with a boomerang in this game?
Kill what?
The spark.
I do not believe you can, but I will try it.
Because I know in one of the... Nope. Guess that's just the Game Boy game.
Yeah.
Look at that 3D.
And there's Moldworm.
Hi. Oh. Did this knock us down a lot?
Yep.
Well. How do we get out? Oh, Jesus.
Thankfully, with the golden sword, I don't think it'll take that many hits to actually kill it, so... So long as we can keep from... doing that again and again and again.
Does it reset every time you fall?
The health does.
Lovely.
Oh, jeez. For a second, I thought you killed it in one hit.
I was hoping.
2 hits. Well...
Something dang. Oh, that's what dang. Got a... best shot two.
Imagine if we didn't have the gold sword here.
Entire game, no sword upgrades. Final destination. Fox only. That's good.
Sure, you play that.
Mean Final Destination.
Star Fox only, no items. Let's go.
Huh. Here we go.
This is it?
Is that not Mothra? No, it is Ganon.
Nope, it
no,
is
it's...
Aghanim.
Aghanim Nam.
Aghanim Nam.
Aghanim? This bastard.
Does he have some new tricks?
It's like a really big wizrobe.
So, the most, like, thick shadow obviously is the real shadow.
Yeah.
Yes.
Still makes it a little bit hard to tennis him, though.
Especially since he keeps shooting the fake ball.
Yeah. I'm not sure if you can bounce the bears into him.
I think you can.
I hope so. That would make this a little bit easier.
Might as well try it.
Well,
apparently you can. Apparently you can. So.
Well, that's good to know. I'll try. It means I don't have to focus on his only. So.
Skill, Idren. Skill. Oh, this is prime. Oh my god. You know what? This is like that bullet hell that I had against the angry dummy in Undertale. Like, I had to try to evade the missiles and get it to hit him, but I just couldn't do it.
Yeah. That's three. It's not playing by normal boss rules, though, it sounds like.
It is.
What if you need to do seven?
Ah.
We die 3 or 4 times. all on top of each other? That's a good tactic. You just kill yourself there.
It was 6. Close, Roxy. Close.
Aghanim reveals himself as Phantom Ganon.
Disgusting.
Follow that bat!
I like that the bird can still get us within the actual pyramid.
In the dark world.
He just... Oh god, I forgot about this.
Didn't think it was a pyramid of power for nothing, did you?
I didn't ask you to give me the Triforce. I'm just gonna take it.
I mean, that's his...
Oop.
Tricky asshole.
Here we come to the Demon King, Ganon.
Probably should have healed first.
Probably.
I healed you, right? It's fine.
He'll die at some point. That'll heal him.
Yeah.
I see he's immune to arrows and teleports.
Well, or is he just blocking them like surely the golden sword would be good enough for this? Like this part of it?
Let's try it.
If we can get close. Yep.
Yep.
What if you just move around him in a circle?
Just orbit him.
Okay, you just gotta do it when he doesn't have a trident out.
Speaking of...
Knocked in the back of the head. What a way to go.
Oh my.
Takes a lot of hits. Oh, there's fire, right?
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, we're in a new phase.
Oh, fire bats. Oh, Jesus. That's good, you say.
Well, yeah, because there's like 5 phases to this, yeah.
Yeah.
Jesus.
That means he did enough damage to move on.
Yep.
And he did enough damage to nearly kill us a second time.
Oh god, Idran.
Well.
Good thing you're stocked up.
Yeah.
Got all those fairies.
I wonder if you would have an easier time if you just use another fairy now.
I do have blue potion that I'm holding on to until I use my last fairy. That'll put me at full health.
Okay.
So.
Oh no.
If you're gonna use the new phase, if you're gonna use the blue potion, you could also use the thing in invincibility.
Oh, that's a good
the
point.
The blue stuff. Just to, like, save a bit of health.
It would be great if he could just bypass that. After all, he is a boss.
Maybe next time try hitting him before he summons the fire keys?
Good idea.
The thing.
And I would bet we don't want to fall off here.
So is there, like, a time limit on this? Of however long it takes him to destroy the entire floor?
Yeah!
Oh, you're doing well, lad, but can you break through the secret technique of darkness?
Secret?
Underheart!
Oh, what's he going to do now?
Oh.
Oh shit, it's an island. He can't escape.
It's dark.
Oh, he's blue. Dabba dee dabba die.
Oh shit. Oh no!
Didn't think it'd be that easy, did you?
Ooh. Motherfucker.
Oh no!
That was just trolling.
I hope that doesn't reset him entirely.
I would be super pissed.
He's like, I'm invisible, and you're like, where are you? And he's like,
right here.
What did he?
Yeah, no shit. No shit.
We did that, don't worry.
So, before I go back...
Get a million fairies.
Ganon. Yeah.
I like just how defeated you sound, like just, yeah, something I should do. Okay, now take a red potion and drink it again, or that. Are those little guys still called chews?
Those are different things. These are buzzwobs.
Oh, okay.
Very descriptive.
I was thinking of Wind Waker.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think those made an appearance until Majora's Mask?
Sounds right.
Because I think that's when the chew jelly first appeared.
Yeah. They're so fucking annoying. I thought they were like weird slugs. Reminded me of Flubber.
But good for potions.
Okay.
The Flubber's adorable.
Flubber's a little shit.
Attempt number two.
What if it restarted the fight?
Then I would be sad.
Let's
at least now we're fully stocked up on all the potions ever.
For now.
We did a bad thing here. Well, that was faster.
Phase two already?
Yeah. Probably because Adren knows now. He knows to fight. He can win!
And knowing is half the battle.
The other half is surviving.
Just go for it. Go for it. Go for it. Go for it.
Have the courage by default.
Goodbye, floor.
Well, got this far without dying. That's a good sign.
Mm.
Just keep away from the ledges.
I used to imagine invisibility being one of those things where, like, it's not, like, I used to wonder if it was something where, like, if you're invisible, nobody else can see you, obviously, but does that mean that someone else is invisible can see you?
That's a good question.
So if you're invisible, you just go to the land of the invisible people?
Yeah, like, that kind of thing.
I mean, Lord of the Rings.
Mm.
Can see other ring wraiths when they're invisible.
Yeah.
And we all know that's the story which means everything. Makes all the rules.
Oh, that that's 2 arrows in.
And that's like 13 fireballs in us.
That sucks that you have to like switch out between the arrows and the fire rod.
A little bit.
Not anymore.
Oh. Is this it?
Arrow sucker.
Is he dead?
And one heart.
Oh my god, Idran!
One heart.
I had another fairy left, I'm pretty sure.
Congratulations. Well,
and two potions.
Not letting me go into my menu, so.
Now you get to finally do the thing.
Look at that 3D.
Whoa. 3D.
I am the essence of the Triforce.
Do you think anyone's Triforce. Ever tried to draw the Triforce as an anthropomorphic character yet?
I'm sure someone has. It's the internet.
That would be Bill Cipher.
Yeah, but then, like, if someone's already drawn it for the purpose of the internet, that can only lead to one conclusion, that it was for Rule 34.
Yeah.
The internet is a disturbing place.
Let's see. Anthropomorphic Triforce.
What if you tell the Triforce, like, my wish is to marry you?
My wish is
Therefore, I get more wishes. Infinite wishes.
I think it would break apart because that means you symbolize love, so good luck with that. I'm surprised. Google has failed me on this one.
Now we have to do it. We have to create the first anthropomorphic Triforce.
You're the artist here, Roxy.
I will not touch that with a 10-foot pole. What if I just draw the Triforce with two little stubs for legs? It ends up being like Bill Cipher's like mother or some shit.
Okay,
that's the theory.
This is the best I could find.
I'm so angry.
I'll have to check that out after the video because I've got Firefox closed right now for RAM.
Think of the wish in your heart, Idran. Stroke the Triforce gently.
I would like Tostitos. That is my wish.
The Return of the King.
That's a different series altogether.
He's not dead anymore.
Oh.
Hey.
Is that his wish then? That the king
knights
didn't
are all
die?
Back. The sage isn't dead either.
What if Link was just like, I want everyone who is dead to have come back?
That
Except my uncle, though, because fuck that guy.
That wish would include Ganon, though.
So much friends. Well, you can't be good in half measures.
I can try.
Vultures rule the desert. The true king.
Oh, hey, there's that thief guy. Who said that he gave up things? The bully makes a friend. It's the two people in the dark world that were transformed.
Yeah.
His head is still shaped like a ball.
Oh, your uncle recovers and lives.
And has a shittier sword than you and I. Like, Uncle, I saved you. Also, I'm so much better than you now. Look
Uncle,
at the sweet blingin' gear
my
I got.
Sword throbs in my hand.
No.
Man, Zora's changed a lot between this and
Zora's got
Majora's
hotter.
Mask.
Zora's got hotter.
Oh my.
Which one is this?
Actually, it's a different species of Zora.
Subcross, halves, demi-species, something. But yeah, there's Sea Zora and River Zora. River Zora are the ones that spit fireballs.
Weren't the Lumberjacks... Was it, Oh, hey, Flute Boy's back.
Hey.
Fuck you, Flute Boy. Hey. Fuck you.
Hey, his story
Weren't
was
those
sad.
Were two Lumberjacks a triplet, though?
They were.
Fucking die, Who's that's what
third?
Happens.
She's just sitting
please tell
on
me, Please tell me Venus was the really ugly one.
Yeah.
Nah.
Aw... I'm disappointed! The little dwarven swordsmiths were adorable.
Yeah.
In my headcanon, they're gay married.
I can accept that. That's mine now, too.
Oh, good. Grandma's not a fairy anymore.
Yeah, and the bug-catching kid isn't sick anymore. He got sick, if you remember back when, from the evil wind blowing off the Death Peak.
The lost old man of Death Peak.
Can't fucking leave, though. He can't leave, though. He's stuck. The stumps are back. This asshole's gonna get blown off the damn mountain.
The invincible thief.
What a dickbag.
Alright, Robin Hood, chill.
I think that's a lie.
Well, until A Link Between Worlds came out, it wasn't.
Yes.
I can't remember, was A Link to the Past chronologically like the very end game?
It's the end of this world. Well, it was at the time.
Yeah.
A Link Between Worlds is like a century after it.
Okay.
Well, this wraps up A Link to the Past.
Thank fucking God. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
You did it.
You lived.
We did it.
No, you did it. You really did it. And Snow helped.
We've got to thank Chris, too, by the way. Can't forget him, since he was in one of these, too.
Who, Chris?
Yep.
Yeah, Chris did well.
Well, thanks, Chris, and thanks, everybody, for watching.
Yep.
Are we going to let the credits play out?
I think so, yeah.
Are we going to talk over them?
Yes, we are. So, next up in this sequence, we're of course going to do another Zelda game. I thought about letting the choice be up to you, Ambi, but I think for the sake of showing off lore, there's really only one direction we want to go next. This Link's adventure does continue, but we're going to want a little bit more backstory before we see what the last Knight of Hyrule does next in his life. So, we are going to go back and see a little bit of backstory of one of the earlier Links, one of the earlier Zeldas, and the origins of the Demon King of Thieves, Ganondorf Dragmire.
That sounds pretty.
Dragmire? Was that always his last name?
It's the American translation of the manual, made it up for the Super Nintendo version, and it's part of my own headcanon, because I like the name. It's officially made up by Nintendo of America, though, not from the actual Japanese developers.
Not by Miyamoto himself.
Yeah. Here, by the way, we've got the people who can blame for the translations. Make Bildorf and Biltrine it.
Sue them for writing "It Throbs in Your Hand."
What interesting names, though.
Well, he's just trying in his best.
Fucking penises up. So what does that mean, Adrian? Like, what Zelda game officially with the title?
Ocarina of Time.
Nice.
Done.
Special thanks. Super Mario Club.
Yep.
Mega Man Club.
Fucking Mega Man Club!
The Super Mario Club's actually, that's the fan QA team that they kind of have beta test games. They let you join it, and they choose some of them to QA their games as they go forward. That's why you'll see the special thanks for a lot of the first party stuff.
Cool. Huh. Let's all join it. Become beta testers.
Aww, Iwata.
Yeah.
Rest in peace, dear friend. So, Adrian, who are you asking to join you on Ocarina of Time?
Everyone, probably. Probably gonna do the same thing as we did in Link to the Past.
Oh,
now we get to
sister.
Yep, we get to see just how bad I did.
Ah!
I'm waiting for Skullwood to pop up. Oh, better than I remembered. I guess overall I didn't actually have game over.
No, that's because you had to restart it because of that lost save file, because Ambi.
Oh, yeah. That's erased from history, though. That no
sure.
happened.
There is a timeline, though, that says that says the truth. And I don't think it's counting like the fact that like fairies revive you.
It doesn't count. The Super Nintendo version did though.
I would count that because I'm an asshole.
The Super Nintendo version also counted every time you saved and quit though.
Yes,
it's a little unfair.
What? Okay, that's a bit much.
Yeah.
If you don't complete it in one run, you let the world fall into darkness forever. Congratulations.
That's the way it should be played.
If you don't do it in one run, it's not perfect.
All right, well, thank you again, everyone. I was glad to have everyone around for this one. It's a really great set of episodes this time.
Hey.
And come back, all of our people watching this, next time for Ocarina of Time, and of course, more Chrono Trigger, which is still chugging along, but getting closer to the end.
Yeah.
Hey. And maybe even some other games?
Hopefully.
Hopefully. Hey.
You two have anything in the pipeline, Ambi and Roxy?
I've been wanting to record Oxenfree for a million years, but...
Oh, I don't know Oxenfree.
I'm in my last week of finals and then graduating, so then that'll be the end. And I plan on finishing Layers of Fear soon, and there's this game I've heard of, Stasis? That came out last year that apparently is really good.
I don't think I know that one either.
Apparently it's depressing, but
I'm looking forward to all of them.
Yeah.
Nothing better than a depressing game.
It's in space and mutants apparently. It's bound to happen. It's bound to be depressing.
Yep. How about you, Ambi? Any plans you had in mind?
Well, if you can show me how to possibly use an emulator.
No.
No, probably not. Then maybe Bomberman Advance.
I would support that.
You and your
Roxy.
Yeah, and then who is he going to come to asking, okay, so how do I edit videos? He's going to come to your ass for that, not me.
That's fine with me.
He's going to be like, so Idrin, I've left in the Dropbox file the audio and the video. Have fun.
If we figured it out, Ambi can figure it out.
I think you overestimate.
So much.
This is
confidence.
The kid who deleted his Tumblr theme. Somehow just completely fucked it over and I had to fix it. I don't trust him.
That sounds about right.
We'll see how things go. And Snow, any last stuff you want to plug? Probably not LP stuff, but...
Do good, kids. Subscribe, like, comment, and keep watching.
Sounds good. So keep checking us out, and for the sake of Chris, keep checking out Sweet Fighters, of course. And this will be it.
Me! Thank you, everyone.
And Roxy. You're part of Raptor Squad Incorporated.
Me!
I was talking about Outsiders.
Me!
Outsiders. All right, yes, check out the Rockster as well.
Final tip, don't be a dick. Don't be a dick.
Yeah.
All right, thanks, guys.
Until next time.
And may the way of the hero lead to the Triforce.
Oh my fucking god. Bye.